Hi everyone! In today's video, I wanted to share a fun way that you or your students can spice up your Google Slides, and that is with word art. Now, if you've seen my video on how to create a meme in Google Slides, it's word art that creates that meme-ish looking text. But there's so much more that you can do. You can play with fonts, you can play with colors and gradients. The screen is an example of what not to do with three different fonts. Colors arranged in different ways, but it shows you the possibilities to liven up and have some fun with your slides. So here's how it works. Whenever I'm creating Google Slides, I hate these boxes, so I either select them and press the delete button or go to layout and choose blank. That gives me a nice blank template. So to create word art, you're going to go to insert, word art, and here's where you're going to type. Now this tiny text under the box is super helpful, and I have to read it each time. It says, use enter to save, or use shift enter for multiple lines. So I'm going to type, welcome. Now if I want an additional line, I could do shift enter, and then type a line. But to go ahead and insert this, I'm just going to hit enter, and there is my word art. Now the fun thing about word art is, think of it as an image. You can grab from the sides, corners, wherever to make this look however you want and to size it however you wish, particularly if you're layering it on an image. But before you do that, I recommend you choose your font. So come up here to fonts, and you've got lots of fun different fonts to use. It's Impact that I recommend if you're doing a meme to get that look. This is like a video game. Maybe I'll try that. It's got that pixelated look, and you can see that is way too big. So again, you can use the corners to resize and however you wish it to be. I'm happy with that. Here's where the real fun begins with the colors. You have the paint bucket, which is going to fill the inside of your letters. So if I choose that, you have solid and you have all of these choices. What I think is most fun is gradient. So with gradient, you can have like an ombre effect. So let's say I'm going to choose this blue one, and you can see it goes from light to dark. But wait, there's more. You can actually create custom ones, and you can see I did some here on the bottom for the previous slide. So to create a custom color, this would be like if you wanted a rainbow or a tie-dye, or if you had a particular theme, you can just click plus, and you can create a custom gradient. So let's say I want to do rainbow because Roy G. Biv is so much fun to say. I'm going to start with red. I'm going to add a gradient stop. You can see it adds it here. I'm going to slide it over and do orange, and add another one, and do yellow, add another one, G, green, add another one, there's my blue, we'll choose this blue, add another one, change the color, let's do that, we'll add another one, change the color, do that light purple. And so you can totally move these around and get those lines as thick or as thin as you want them. Again, totally up to you. So much creativity here. And let's see, this one's last one's blue. Let's go ahead and make that red again. That will give kind of a, I don't like that. Let's do a darker purple. There we go. So if I'm happy with this, I can click OK. Now I've got a rainbow one. But wait, there's even more. Because here you've got a linear. So if you want to change it, I can come up here, that plus again. It pulls up the one you just worked on. But notice you have all these different types. So you can do a radial where it's going to spin out from the center. If you want it to spin out from the center, or you could do the top left, bottom, so on and so forth. Let's be fun and do like kind of a top left. And so that's what it's going to look like. I can click OK. You can see it's kind of sweeping across. And, but if you don't like that, again, you can come click the plus. You can even do the linear. We had it going up and down. You could change the angle, the across, and there you have it. One last touch that you may want to add to your board art is next to the paint bucket, you also have this border color. And that is the outline across all of these different letters. So you can also do that custom. That might not show up as well, but here's where you could do like a black to make it stand out. And you go right next to the border color. You can choose the weight. Right now it's only 1 pixel, so it's very thin, but let's change it to 8. And you can see it jumps out. This could be white. And then what if this background was like a gray color? See how you can use word art to really make your text jump out? One thing to keep in mind is when you are using text in Google Slides, your prime objective is to communicate. So you do want to make sure you don't go overboard like I did in this first slide, because in here, this is very difficult to read and it doesn't stand out as much. In terms of accessibility, you want to keep in mind that you do have color contrast, or go too wild with their colors that students can no longer read your information. Just a note, WordArt works in Google Slides. It is also available inside Google Drawing. It is not available in Google Docs. So if you learn something new and look forward to spicing up your Google Slides with some WordArt, give this video a thumbs up and consider subscribing for future videos. Until next time, bye everyone.